So hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIV 247. I am Manish Mishra and in this session guys we are going to discuss some questions from the PIV news and some question we are going to discuss from the static part of ESI section of the RBI grade B. Okay, so let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. Or iska jo link hai that you will find in the description. Okay, so let's begin with the first question. So first question is, which of the following agencies is implementing Global Understanding of India project, which is a project to understand how the world understands India. इंडिया के बारे में दुनिया में क्या क्या खबरें पहुंचती हैं थ्रू द टेक्स्ट बुक, उसके लिए ये एक प्रोजेक्ट है जिसका नाम है ग्लोबल अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ इंडिया प्रोजेक्ट. ओके, सो द क्वेश्चन इज, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एजेंसीज इज इंप्लीमेंटिंग दिस प्रोजेक्ट. ओके, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस प्रोजेक्ट. सो गाइज, द नेम ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट यू शुड रिमेंबर, द ग्लोबल अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ इंडिया प्रोजेक्ट, एंड इट इज बींग इम्प्लीमेंटेड बाय द इंडियन काउंसिल ऑफ कल्चरल रिसर्च. ओके, Indian Council of Cultural Research is implementing this project, which is known as Global Understanding of India. And this project, guys, is there to understand how the world understands India. किस तरीके से दुनिया जो है इंडिया को समझती है. And the council, what council is doing? So the council is surveying textbooks of more than 200 countries. 200 से ज्यादा countries की जो textbook है उनको सर्वे किया जा रहा है और उसके थ्रू ये देखा जा रहा है कि किस तरीके की इंफॉर्मेशन इंडिया के बारे में प्रोवाइड कराई जा रही है टू द स्टूडेंट्स. ओके, सो ICCR, इंडियन काउंसिल ऑफ कल्चरल रिसर्च, इज सर्वेइंग द टेक्स्ट बुक ऑफ मोर देन 200 कंट्रीज, एंड थ्रू दिस दे आर आइडेंटिफाइंग विच व्हाट टाइप ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन, व्हाट हाउ डीप इंफॉर्मेशन इज प्रोवाइडेड अबाउट इंडिया इन द अब्रॉड इन द फॉरेन कंट्रीज. ओके, and talking more about this, so these are some basic facts. अभी तक कुछ ICCR ने कुछ countries की textbook को survey किया था जिसमें से कुछ facts हमारे सामने हैं. Of course, these are not important for exam. These will not be asked in your exam. But yes, for the basic understanding, let's have a look at this. So in Turkey, India finds only passing mention in the textbook. मतलब Turkey में जो है केवल आते जाते इंडिया का जिक्र होता है. While in Oman and the UAE, there are some inaccuracies in the textbook related to the information about India. In African countries, mention of Gandhi and non-aligned movement exists, but they are not adequate. That is to be, you know, उसको और ज़्यादा हमें enhance करने की ज़रूरत है. In USA, India is depicted largely on the positive side, of course, because USA is a good friend of ours. In European countries, such as Italy, Iceland, India, Ireland, etc., India का कोई खास reference नहीं है, खास ज़्यादा mention नहीं है, और कई जगहों पे तो बिल्कुल नहीं है. Then in some parts of Australia, India has significant references, while some has none. But Australia के कुछ parts में India के references हैं, बाकी कुछ parts ऐसे भी हैं जहाँ पे बिल्कुल भी references नहीं दिए गए हैं. Okay, these ये सारी चीजें आपको याद रखने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. That is just for the basic understanding. Now let's move on to the question. So guys, the question is, okay, so the question is, which of the following agencies is implementing this project? So guys, the agency is what? Indian Council of Cultural Research. Option E will be the correct answer here. Okay, and now guys, let's move on to the question number 2. Which of the following countries is not under the special watch list with respect to the violation of religious freedom? So guys, recently United States of America, उन्होंने कुछ 10 countries हैं, 10 countries को रखा है in they have designated 10 countries as the concern for violation of religious freedom. Okay, violation of religious freedom. So there are 10 countries in the world which are a concern for violation of religious freedom, and these are the 10 countries, guys. You have to remember all the names of all the 10 countries, which are Pakistan, China, Myanmar, Eritrea, Iran, Nigeria, North Korea, Saudi Arabia, Tajikistan and Turkmenistan. And remember one thing, Nigeria ko hai सबसे पहली बार ये डेजिग्नेशन मिला है. इट इज द फर्स्ट टाइम दैट नाइजीरिया हैज बीन डेजिग्नेटेड एज द कंसर्न ऑफ स्पेशल कंसर्न अंडर दिस कैटेगरी. एंड ऑफ कोर्स नाइजीरिया इज द फर्स्ट सेक्युलर डेमोक्रेसी. ओके, इट इज द फर्स्ट सेक्युलर डेमोक्रेसी विच इज बीइंग केप्ट अंडर दिस कंसर्न. ओके, सो रिमेंबर दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम दिस न्यूज. ओके, so these are the 10 countries, and talking more about this news, so Comoros, Cuba, Nicaragua and Russia are on a special watch list. ये चार countries जो हैं वो special watch list में, इनके ऊपर particular concern की category में नहीं रखा है. देन सुडान एंड उज्बेकिस्तान, ये दो कंट्रीज ऐसे हैं दैट हैव बीन रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम द स्पेशल वॉच लिस्ट बेस्ड ऑन द सिग्निफिकेंट प्रोसेस दैट मेड बाय देयर गवर्नमेंट्स. ओके, सो इसमें से आपको ये तीन चीजें याद रखनी है, द नेम ऑफ फोर कंट्रीज विच आर अंडर विच आर ऑन अ स्पेशल वॉच लिस्ट, टू कंट्रीज विच आर रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम द कैटेगरी ऑफ स्पेशल वॉच लिस्ट, देन यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ दीज 10 कंट्रीज, देन यू ऑल्सो हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट नाइजीरिया has become the first secular democracy to get this concern. Okay, and now let's move on to the question. So which of the following countries is not under the special watch list? So Comoros is there, Cuba is there, Nicaragua is there, Sudan is not there. Sudan and Uzbekistan have been removed from this special watch list. So therefore the correct answer should be what, guys? Option D. Okay, and now let's move on to the question number 3 and 4. So guys, question number 3 and 4 are based on some government schemes. So let's talk about these questions. So there is a passage that you have to read and then you have to identify the scheme. A scheme was launched on Gandhi Jayanti in the year 2014 with the twin objective of cleanliness and providing livelihood to safai karmcharis, jo cleaners hote hain unko लाइवलीहुड प्रोवाइड कराने के लिए, एंड ऑफ कोर्स क्लीनलीनेस प्रमोट करने के लिए द स्कीम वाज लॉन्च्ड इन द ईयर 2014 ऑन द गांधी जयंती, दैट इज ऑन 2nd of October. ओके, एंड लिबरेटेड मैनुअल स्केवेंजर्स के लिए भी है ये. सो अंडर द स्कीम अ सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ लोन इज प्रोवाइडेड एट नॉट मोर देन 4% रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट फॉर कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ कम्युनिटी टॉयलेट्स एंड प्रोक्योरमेंट ऑफ सैनिटेशन रिलेटेड व्हीकल्स. सो गाइज, इन द स्कीम एवरीथिंग इज गिवन, सब कुछ गिवन है आपको, लॉन्चर गिवन है, द बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव इज गिवन, लोन दिया जाता है ये भी गिवन है. ओके, सो कैन यू आइडेंटिफाई द स्कीम नाउ, एंड रिमेंबर इट इज नॉट स्वच्छ भारत योजना, बिकॉज गाइज दैट स्कीम डज नॉट टॉक्स अबाउट द सफाई कर्मचारी एंड द मैनुअल स्कैवेंजर्स. ओके, सो डोंट कंफ्यूज इट विद द स्वच्छ भारत मिशन, दिस इज नॉट स्वच्छ भारत मिशन, रिमेंबर दिस. सो कैन यू आइडेंटिफाई द स्कीम नाउ. ओके, लेट मी गिव यू वन मोर हिंट. This scheme is implemented by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, which is currently headed by Thavarchand Gehlot. And let me give you one more hint. This scheme, the implementing agency to implement this scheme is National Safai Karmchari Finance and Development Corporation. National Safai Karmchari Finance and Development Corporation is the implementing agency of this scheme. So I think that you are now able to identify the scheme, guys. So the scheme is what? Swachhata Udyami Yojana. Option B, Swachhata Udyami Yojana is the correct answer. Swachhata means cleanliness, Udyami means entrepreneur. Okay, so option B is the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 4. So again, there is a passage that you have to read and identify the scheme. So a scheme was launched by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. Okay, so ministry is given, Ministry of Women and Child Development, it is given in the year 2016. So launch year is also given, which means two things are already given. To prevent trafficking of women and children for commercial sexual exploitation and to facilitate rescue and rehabilitation of the victims. Basic objective is given, human trafficking se mahilaon aur bachcho ko bachane ke liye this scheme was launched in the year 2016 by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. The scheme has 5 components. One more hint, which are prevention, rescue, rehabilitation, reintegration and repatriation. And all women and children, irrespective of their age, who are either vulnerable to and victim of trafficking are the eligible beneficiaries of this scheme. So guys, I think aur isme kuch bhi dene ke liye nahi hai, sab kuch aapko given hai. So you just have to read the passage and identify the scheme. And I think you can now identify, yes, the scheme is what? Ujjwala scheme. Okay. It is Ujjwala. Don't confuse this scheme with Ujjwala Yojana of which is LPG. That is Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. That is just Ujjwala. Okay. And under this scheme, rescue is provided to the victims of human trafficking and to all the women and child, irrespective of their age. And remember, don't confuse this scheme with one-stop center scheme. This scheme is to provide support to women who are affected by violence. Okay, who are affected by violence. Either it is ये जो violence है ये घर का भी हो सकता है और बाहर का भी हो सकता है. Okay, so don't confuse this with one stop center, and remember one thing also, that this scheme is for the girls who are above 18 years of age. Okay, and while Ujjwala में ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है. Okay, so therefore the correct answer is what? Option B, Ujjwala. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear, and if you have any doubts, guys, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.